So I think the crisis has shown that macroeconomics has to be rethought, and that we need to put much more, you know, the role of financial intermediaries, banks, and credit at the heart of macroeconomic models. So this had been done already in growth models. I mean, and there had been also work, you know, by Bernanke himself and co-authors, putting, you know, credit constraints, but not so much putting banks and financial intermediaries at the heart of macroeconomic models. So I think that will change. I think we will see much more in macro with including the financial intermediaries. Well, I think, you know, we've got the worst of the financial part of the crisis is behind us, but now still the real side of the economy is still suffering from the fact that you had a big credit crunch. So it will take a while before economies recover, you know, get back to the growth rate they had before. And we don't know how long it would take, if ever, to recover the loss in GDP that they incurred due to the crisis. That might take a long while, in fact. Yeah, I think the key things, the key ingredients, I mean, the work I've been doing with co-authors and work done by others as well, shows that, you know, the kind of the key to success, to successful universities and to universities that, you know, produce good publications, good patents, contributes to growth, are three keys. You need well-funded universities. So, for example, the U.S. spends over 36,000 euros per student per year on education, whereas, for example, the EU spends four times less per student per year. I mean, there is no mystery. If we want to succeed, first we have to spend much more on universities. The second thing is that we need autonomous universities. We need that universities themselves decide, you know, whom to hire, or wage policy, the content of programs, student selection and things. That autonomy is very important. And third, you need competition among universities. We need competition for grants. Grants should play an important role. And universities should compete to obtain these grants, like NSF grants in the US. Here, we have the European Research Council, but there will be other grants. You have the research assessment exercise in the UK, which is another way to get grants when you perform well. So competition for grants is, I think, also very important. So autonomy, competition, and funding are three major components of success. I think the key issues are the following. The issues are, we need, of course, to have policies that discourage consumption and production of fuel-using goods, and encouraging people to consume more other types of energy, which is not non-fuel energy. I think the problem is that, of course, you need to have, it's a political economy problem, that it's not popular to put a carbon tax in a country. That's one problem. Another problem is also that we need to convince less developed countries that they should also embark in grid innovations. And they would tell us, well, look, when you industrialized, you polluted. Why should you deny us the right to do what you done? But the difference is that there are some countries, not many in the world, like Japan, like Denmark, that have developed clean technologies. There is also the nuclear energy and a second generation of much safer nuclear plants. So we should diffuse those technologies to other countries. But of course, those who produce those technologies get rents from having innovated there. So how can you get governments in OECD countries to compensate those innovators and still be able to diffuse the technologies to less developed countries. So you have all the debate on intellectual property and subsidizing diffusion of clean technologies, which I think is also a kind of delicate debate. Then there is another debate which is also important, which is that some countries turn into what we call pollution heavens. That means that they say, well, we don't want to play the game, like Australia, for example. We are happy to keep going dirty because we think it's good for employment. But then trade policy should be there as well to make sure that such countries are penalized by trade policies. So I think it's a mixture of carbon tax and subsidies to production and diffusion of clean technologies. I think the carbon tax alone is too costly a way to deal with policies. You need a combination. And I think we should do both, actually.